Very good evening, children. Yes. Yeah. So today we will learn about two wonderful Bhagavad Gita shlokas, and also we will learn a beautiful story we will listen to. Okay. Before that, let's meditate. After that, I will give chance to every one of you to speak. Okay. So please close your eyes. Sit very relaxedly. I think few new children are there. Sit relaxedly. Take a comfortable posture. Okay. Sit relaxedly. Cross your feet. Clasp your fingers. And keep it down on your lap. Yeah. Now close your eyes. And observe your natural breath. The in-breath and the out-breath. We have to be just with it. Be with it. If you are getting any thoughts, just cut the thoughts and again be with your breath. You're getting any thoughts, just cut the thoughts and again observe your natural breath. With wonderful music, let us meditate. Till I say okay, please don't open your eyes. I want every one of you to close your eyes. Pranavi, Kalyan, every one of you. Be with your breath. You're doing a wonderful job. Just continue. Few more minutes. Be with your breath. Don't open your eyes till I say okay. Last 3 minutes. Be with your breath. Last 3 minutes, be with your breath.
Ma pa re sa re pa ni sa
last few seconds, children. Be with your breath. Now, just by closing your eyes itself, let us thank Mother Earth. Let us thank our parents for taking care of us so well. Let us thank our healthy, strong body. Let us thank our breath. Let us thank Patriji for teaching us this great meditation technique. Let us thank everyone who are helping us directly or indirectly. Now, slowly place your both hands on your eyes. Keep it for 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Slowly open your eyes and come out of meditation. Yes, you all have done very well. Very good. Keep it up. Let's clap for ourselves. More. I want more. You got a lot of energy, right? From music, from meditation. More. I want more. Let me see how much energy I've got. Only this much? Only this much? Yes. Yes. Very good. Very good. Thank you. Thank you so much, children. Wow. That's amazing. All the children are wonderful. A lot of energy. Very good. Yes. So now, yes, Pranavi, do you have any doubt? Can you unmute? Yes, Pranavi. You did not unmute, sweetie. You need to press on the audio button there. Red color one. It will be like a mic symbol there. See on the corner. Otherwise, you take the help of your parents. No, I cannot hear. Unless you unmute, I cannot hear. How much ever you speak, I cannot hear.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, yesterday I didn't do the drawing. Sai Kripakan Saravaka had to me. They showed drawing and I did the drawing.
Okay, very good. Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pranavi. Thank you so much. So, okay, children. So now let's learn the 2 Bhagavad Gita shlokas. Before that, I will tell you a wonderful story. Earlier, I think I have discussed the story of Astavakra, right? How many of you remember? Sorry, not Astavakra. What is his name? Ekalavya. Yeah. Yes, very good. So from that story, I want to take few more points. So Ekalavya, I told you, he's from a small tribal place. They are the, his father is a king of that place. So his father, what he wants is, if he dies, someone should be there to take care of their tribe. So he wants his son Ekalavya to become a very strong person, not only becoming a warrior, apart from that, he want to want him to go to Gurukula and learn everything about administration, about self-realization, means about meditation, all this spiritual knowledge he wants him to learn. So that's how he will go to Dronacharya's Gurukulam. And then we know the story that Arjuna will not accept, and he'll be sent out, okay, of that Gurukulam. So what happens? He feels very much sad. He feels very much dejected, lost. Why? Because he came with a lot of enthusiasm to learn all the things from Dronacharya. Dronacharya is a very great guru. And the way he teaches, the way he expresses, the way he shows patience towards teaching the knowledge, he's a very great guru, Dronacharya. So when he himself says, you are not fit here, you go away from this place, from the Gurukulam, he feels very lost, very deserted. He don't know what to do. He wants to go back to his place, to his tribal village. But since he is a meditator, you know, Ekalavya is started meditation from the age of 7 years. So when he was 7 years old, he started meditating. He used to meditate every day. So when he was sent to Gurukulam, his age was 20 years. So when he was sent from that Gurukulam, he did not get it. What he thought is, in the beginning he thought he's lost when he want to go to his place. But he sat there, he meditated, then he thought, let me see what is there ahead for me to learn. So what he did in the forest, he did not go to their hometown or village. No, he was alone. But his meditation gave him that courage to face that tough challenge, tough situation. So he went to the village, he went to the forest, he made a small hut, and he also made with the mud, he made the statue of Dronacharya. We all know this story, right? Then the mud, to get hardened, he used his meditative powers and he made it very hard. Mm-hmm. And then what he did was, he started meditating there. On the first sight itself, in the first sitting there, he saw Shiva. Okay, so Shiva told, go to Brahma. This is all happening in his meditation. Okay, then Brahmadev told, okay, go to Saraswati, she may help you. Why? Because who is the goddess of studies? Whom will we pray when we start our studies in the school or anywhere? Whom will we pray? Can you give me in the chat? Which god we will pray? I will definitely tell, but Ashika, you tell. Yes, Saraswati. Very good, sister. So we pray Saraswati when we start our studies. Why? Because Saraswati is the ma of our knowledge. So she is a goddess of knowledge. So Brahmadev told, okay, go to Saraswati. The amsh of Saraswati is Sharada Mata, Sharada Devi. So go to her, she may help. So in the meditation, he goes and meets Sharada Devi. Then Sharada Devi will see his dedication and interest towards learning that knowledge. Who? Ekalavya. And she teaches everything. She told, I will guide you. Whatever you want, whatever knowledge you want, I will definitely guide you. Who says this? Sharada Devi. Then from that day, Sharada Devi teaches everything to Ekalavya. Means in the meditation itself, she teaches. Yes, mm-hmm. Saraswati is also called as Sharada Devi. Okay, so then what he learns, everything, all the arts, that archery, everything, he becomes expert in just 40 days. Whatever Arjuna learns for 7 years, the Ekalavya becomes expert in all those things just only in 40 days. With the help of Sharada Devi's knowledge. So then that's how he become so much expert. Directly from Saraswati Mata, Sharada Devi, he has learned all the knowledge. Why Sharada Devi taught him? She has seen his... Can anyone tell? Can anyone answer? I already told you. What Sharada Devi sees, observes in Ekalavya, what qualities she will see? Yes, dedication. And one more. Yes, perfect, Nikhila. Dedication and interest. She sees, she observes that dedication and interest towards learning, towards taking the knowledge, working on it. She observes that and then she teaches. If we don't have dedication, if we don't have interest, nobody will teach us children. If somebody teaches also, we cannot understand. We cannot excel in that. So what do we need to get to grasp everything, to become expert in everything? We need dedication and interest. You all are dedicatedly coming, not even missing one day to meditation. So in the past 2 months, 3 months, how much you have learned? Yes or no? Yeah. So why? You all are having the dedication to know about yourself, to know about meditation more and more, to practice meditation. That's why you are excelling so much. You are getting a lot of opportunities. So wherever it is, children, we need to have dedication. Means whatever it may be, I will do it. Whatever may happen, I will attend the class. I will practice meditation. Even if I'm tired, I'll practice meditation. I'll not miss meditation. That is dedication, children. So anywhere that practice, that dedication and interest should be there. Only when you show interest towards meditation or towards learning the spiritual science or towards learning your subjects, only when you show that interest, you'll understand. You'll go into the depth of that subject. You'll enjoy even, you know, only when you show interest, you'll enjoy more and more. Only when you go inside, you'll enjoy it. In the top layer, if you see, oh, mathematics is very difficult for me. Oh my God, writing is very difficult for me. Only from the top layer, you feel it difficult. But once when you sit, show in little interest and sit and start writing, when you go, no, you'll enjoy. When you're in that process, you'll enjoy it. You'll mix with it. You'll become one with it. You'll not see writing as differently. You'll not see mathematics differently. You'll become one with it. You'll enjoy. You'll start enjoying it. So you need that interest, children, towards anything. So only Sharada Devi taught Ekalavya by seeing his dedication and interest. And within 40 days, just 40 days, he has learned everything. All the arts, whatever he wanted, archery or Vedas, whatever it may be, he has learned in just 40 days with his dedication and interest. See, whatever act we should do perfectly, wonderfully. Even if it is for 10 minutes, whatever we are taking, let's do it perfectly. Somewhere, if our mind is on games or you sit for studies, somewhere your mind will go. You have to get it. Hey, come on. You should pull it. I am now only with my mathematics. I don't want anything else in the whole world. I don't want anything else. Such interest, such a dedication if you show, you'll finish it in minutes, seconds, children. It won't take much time. Only when that interest is not there, dedication is not there, you'll sit in front of books hours and hours, but nothing will go inside. What is the use? Just apply this technique from today. Okay, finish all your homeworks or reading works, everything. Then you do all other things. Yesterday I told you, know, keep always be with colors. Every day be with colors. Sing, dance, play, everything you have to do, children. Okay, yeah. And then Ekalavya, what he does, you know, afterwards what happened, we all know. He has learned that and Arjuna will see his great art. With that, by pulling the pausing the arrows onto the dog's mouth, he sees that art, and finally, we all know his thumb will be taken away. And afterwards, also, you know what happened? He did not get depressed. Okay, he accepted even that. And then he started teaching. Earlier itself, he started teaching, you know, children, whatever he has learned from Sharada Devi, he immediately started teaching his fellow people. Like that, he made many warriors. He imparted knowledge to many people of their tribes, how to live happily. In everyday life, we'll be facing a lot of challenges. So many things will come to us. How to deal with life realities. He taught everything to everyone. So he not only kept the knowledge for himself, he shared with everyone. Whatever he has, he shared with everyone. So such a great act he has done. And with whatever they are having, they are very happy and they are very satisfied. Contented means satisfied. So this is the story I want to share with you all children. Did you all like it? Yeah, see how meditation has helped him to face the challenge. Ekalavya's challenges are not small ones, very big ones. He wants to learn, but Guru will not teach. He become alone, but still he is not depressed. That courage, that confidence from where he got? From his meditation, from his very young age. So you all are in a wonderful path, children. Don't miss this. Don't stop meditation at any cost. Whatever may happen, wherever you are, don't leave meditation. Don't forget meditation. Because that is the main thing that will keep you connected with yourself. That with your true self. That will help you in all the ways. Okay? Yes, children. So if someone is there in Ekalavya situation, he would have ran away to his village. Because of that situation, that fear, that losingness. So he has got that power from his meditation to face that challenge. And what Ekalavya says is, learn from everyone, every situation. Suppose a person is in front of you. He is just with us now. Learn, try to learn from him. Because from next day or next moment, he may not be with us. So we will miss the learning from him. So from every person, we should learn something or the other. That's what he teaches. And then he says, whatever the situation may be, you be happy. Always try to be happy. Even if it is a sorrowful situation or even if it is a happy situation, you have to be in the blissful state. Why? Because everything we have chosen, our family, our mother, our father, our surrounding, everything we choose and came. When we are coming here, we choose and came. Okay, I want this mother, I want this father, I want this brother, I want such situations. Who has chosen? We have chosen, not anybody else. So be happy in the situations you have chosen. That's what his main teachings are, Ekalavya's teachings are. And to learn from every person, every situation. Yes, children. Now, let's see today's Bhagavad Gita shlokas. Hope everyone has learned the last week's shlokas. Yes, so we are in the today's shlokas are these. So last week's shlokas are Yogastaha Kuru Karmani Sangam Tyaktva Dhananjaya Siddhya Siddhyo Samo Bhutva Samatvam Yoga Uchyate. So in success and failure, take it as in a balanced situation. Don't worry much. Karmajam buddhi yuktahi phalam tyaktva manishinaha janmabandha vinirmuktaha padam gacchantyanamayam. So Krishna is telling to Arjuna all these shlokas. So with buddhi and what to say? Without bothering much about the result, do the karmas, then you will be more happy. So these are the two shlokas. Whoever has learnt it, I will give you opportunity at the end, children. Let's quickly see what are the today's two shlokas. Okay, the first shloka for today is Tasma dasaktaha satatam karyam karma samachara asakto. Hyacharana karma paramapnoti purushaha. Just a second, children. Tasma dasaptaha satatam karyam karma samachara asakto hyacharan karma paramapnoti purushaha. So, whatever act you do, you remove the attachment towards it. Asaktaha means attachment. You leave that attachment and perform the duty. What is your duty? Every day reading, cleaning yourself, keeping your things clean, helping your parents. So many things are there, no? So every day's duties you perform, leaving a attachment to it. And also, don't think about the results. If I do this, okay, I will get good appreciation. That's why I am doing this. No. So leave about that attachment towards every work you do, every karma you perform. Karma means work, our duty. So whatever work you are doing, do it without any attachment, any expectation. Okay, if I speak well, oh, my mother will appreciate or my teacher will appreciate. Keep those expectations and do the work. Asakti means some interest in the result. Leave that and do. That is what Krishna is telling. Then you'll attain the higher state very easily. That is what Krishna is telling in this shloka. So see, in the story today, we have learned that Ekalavya, he did not do his act selfishly. If I do something, I will get more. Whatever he has learned from Sharada Devi, he has nicely told to everyone in their tribe. He taught that to everyone. And he made so many people ready. He made so many people to be happy. See how his act is, how his duty he has done so wonderfully. He is not selfish. So whatever act you do it properly. Selflessly. That is what he is telling in this shloka. Then you will be happy. So let us learn this shloka, children. Let's repeat after me 3 times. Tasma asaktaha satatam karyam karma samachara asakto hyacharan karma param apnoti purushah. One more time, let's repeat. Tasmat asaktaha satatam karyam karma samachara asakto hyacharan karma paramapnoti purushah. One more last time. Tasmat asaktaha satatam karyam कर्म समाचार असक्तो ह्याचरण कर्म परमाप्नोति पुरुषः। So satatam means always. So always, whatever work you do, karma means karma, karya means whatever duty you have, whatever duty you have, do it without any attachment towards the result. Oh, I will get this, that's why I'm doing this. I will get that, that's why I'm doing this. No, leave about it with lot of interest, dedication to every duty. Okay, Ekalavya has done with, learned that or done every task with dedication and that interest. So here Krishna is also telling us the same thing. Leave about the result. Don't be attached to the result. If someone scolds, you know, children, some children will just cry off. Okay, because they're expectant. Oh, only if my parents give me appreciation, I'll be happy. If they scold, I'll get depressed, lose everything, lose that mood, everything. Why they have scolded? Just think of it. Okay, what can I learn? Only if you see that, you'll be happy even in that situation. Okay, so let's leave about the result, attachment towards the result. Then you will do your work very well, more than that. You can be happy. So the next shloka is, यद्यदाचरति श्रेष्ठ स्तत देवेतरो जनः स यत् प्रमाणं कुरुते लोक स्तदनु वर्तते। सो हियर कृष्णा इज टेलिंग टू अर्जुन द श्रेष्ठ मीन्स श्रेष्ठतर मीन्स हूएवर आर very prominent in the society. Whatever they have done in the society, the people will follow. Who don't have the knowledge, they will follow the knowledgeable people. Whatever they do, oh, if he is doing that, it's perfect. So the same thing they will follow. If you see in the villages and all, they'll not have much knowledge. So whatever the educated people do, they think that is correct and they will do it. So, when you are in a society, when you are with everyone, whatever you do, they will get, people will get inspired by you, by your works. They'll get, motivated by your things, and they will also follow the same thing. So, how we have to do our act, we should be very careful with our works. So, here, Sreshta means the best. Yet, yet means the best people, however they will do. Acharati means whatever they will follow. Itaraha means all the others, all the other janaha means people. Tat tat, the same way. Eva means like that only. Saha yet means whatever they say, this is important, they will also follow that only. Kurute, they will follow that. The whole, whole world will follow that. If suppose we all know, society, Gandhiji is a very great person. Okay, in his hand, always there used to be Bhagavad Gita children. Every day he used to read Bhagavad Gita, used to get learnings from Bhagavad Gita. Who? Gandhiji. So whatever he has done, definitely many people will get inspired from him and they will also start learning Bhagavad Gita. Many have in fact got inspired from him. He used to be very cautious about his food. He used to be a vegetarian. If suppose some non-vegetarian person cooks food, he never used to eat it. So he's very careful about his food. So there are many great things from Gandhiji to learn. So whatever the great people, the Sreshta Jana will follow, the other society also follow the same thing. So we should do wonderful things. Suppose you are meditating every day and you are very calm, like means you are very balanced in all situations. You are able to do multiple activities. Okay, you are very active. Then what happens? All the other children also will get inspired by you. Wow, how beautifully Pranavi is meditating. How beautifully Kalyan is doing. Wow, he is into all activities. He is so happy. How Bhuvi is balanced in all situations. So people will get inspired. The way you are, your works, your deeds, your words. Everybody will be observing us, no children. Wherever we are, everybody will be observing us. We also observe everybody, right? Surrounding us. The same way, many will be observing us. So when our acts are good, they will also take that good things. Okay? If you have become a vegetarian, then definitely they will, she became a vegetarian, she became very calm and she's very happy. Then what happens? The other children also will start following. Vegetarianism has that much importance. Okay, let me also follow. So whatever we do, we should be a good example. Yes or no? We should be a good inspiration to everyone. Our acts show us. Our everyday words, acts show us. Show that to everyone, right? So let us be a very good inspiration to everyone. Shall we? Yes, let's be a great examples to everyone. Okay, Pranavi, Aditri, every one of you, let us be a great examples to everyone. Fine? Yeah, very good. Thank you so much. You are already a great examples. Just keep it up. Your experiences are really helping many children. Yes. We have seen how Ekalavya is a great example. Even in tough situations, he took it as a challenge and he faced it. He has nicely learned, got the knowledge from Sharada Devi. Yes? Today's story has got nice relation, no? Thank you so much, children. So let's repeat this shloka 3 times. Yadyadacharati Sreshta Tatta Stata Devetaro Janaha Sa Yat Pramanam Kurute Loka Tadanu Vartate. Yes, next time. Yadyadacharati Sreshta. Yadyadacharati Sreshta Tatta Devetaro Janaha Sat Pramanam Kurute Lokas Tadanu Vartate. All the people will follow the same things. Yeah. One more last time. Yadyadacharati Sreshta Stata Devetaro Janaha Sa Yat Pramanam Kurute Lokas Tadanu Vartate. Yes, children. So this is the shloka. So learn these 2 shlokas well. After the class, I will send the audio in the Telegram group. So accordingly, try to spell it and learn. Okay? Every day spend 2 minutes time for practice. That much is enough. Okay? Every day learn it, then you will get it easily. Show a little interest and dedication towards Bhagavad Gita. It will help you all over your life. Okay? Thank you so much, children. So now let's listen from you all. I'll go in order. Yes, my sister.
Yes, ma'am. I need to tell two Bhagavad Gita shlokas last week, and I need to share my experience, and I have a doubt.
Yes.
Yogastha kuru karmani sangam chaktva dhananjaya siddhya siddhyo samo bhutva samatvam yoga uchyate. And one more, ma'am. Karmajam buddhi yuktahi phalam tyaktva manishinaha janma bandha vinirmuktaha padam gacchantya namayam.
Very good. Perfectly.
Thank you, ma'am. And I want to share my yesterday's experience and today's experience. Yesterday when I was meditating, there was a road. There was no end for that road. Mm-hmm. In the center of that road, the shot put balls, the shot put game. Mm-hmm. That balls were like this kept. Stop. It was like this, ma'am. In that in the outside of that, I was meditating.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Mm. And today, when I was meditating, lastly, we will thank all who help us. When I was thanking Mother Earth, I was experiencing that there was a circle field. I was rotating like this in a circle way.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Good experience. Are
yes,
you
ma'am.
All your experiences?
Ma'am?
Are you writing, noting down all your experiences?
No, ma'am.
You'll forget it, this sister, afterwards. The same experience, ma'am. Continuity will come in somewhere next experience.
Okay, ma'am. From today onwards, I'll write.
I'll write. You write? Take some time every day, maybe before sleeping. Spare 5 minutes. You should see, okay, how my day was from morning to night, how I have spent. Where can I improve? You can check out about yourself. Then meditate and happily go to sleep. 5 minutes a day is enough.
Yes, ma'am. And I have a doubt now, ma'am. Every day I will use this paper pyramid. From yesterday, I and my family started wearing this pyramid. In that, can we wear like this, ma'am, the thread like this on our head?
Yes, yes, no problem. The thread is only to support you. That's it. That it should not be
wrong. Yes, ma'am, in that place there will be cloud, I know, ma'am. So.
Oh, okay. See, energy will be everywhere. Okay. So if you wear thread, third eye won't get activated. So wherever the thread is, it doesn't matter. Only the energy what we get matters in meditation.
Okay, ma'am. And when we are meditating, we didn't want to touch our head to any wall, no, ma'am.
Yes.
We should not touch, right, ma'am?
We should not touch.
We should touch only if...
Anywhere it can be touched. If we keep like this, it should not. This back portion of the head should not touch the wall.
Okay.
Yeah. That's
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sister. Yes. Who is this? Is this Pranavi? Please name with your own names, okay? Gagan. Who is Gagan? Yes, Pranavi. You need to unmute.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
I can tell one two shlokas.
Is it Bhagavad Gita shloka?
No, ma'am.
Another
shloka.
Okay, tell me one. Okay, this is for Bhagavad Gita class, no? We will only tell Bhagavad Gita shloka. as you are new, okay, tell me.
वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निरविघ्नं गुरुवे देवा सर्वकारेषु सर्वदा.
Very good.
Ma'am, when sitting to meditation, we want to keep like this.
Yes, you'll just clasp the fingers like this and you'll just keep it up. No, you should not keep like this. Just like this and you'll keep it up. Only to show you, my fingers are down. No? So I kept here and I have shown you. After that, you can just place it on the lap.
Okay, ma'am.
Very good, Pranavi. Thank you. Yes, Savitri.
Yes, ma'am. Can I tell the second Adhyaya 48th sloka?
Yes.
Yoga Sata Kuru Karmani Sangam Chaktva Dhananjaya Siddhya Siddhyo Samobhutva Samatvam Yoga Uchate.
Yes, perfect.
Ma'am?
In the first word only you need to check. Yoga Staha.
Yoga Staha. Okay, ma'am.
Very
ma'am,
good.
Can I tell today's slokas?
Have you learned it already?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, tell me.
Second Adhyaya, 19th sloka. Tasmad asaktaha. Satatam kariyam karma samachara asakto hyacharan. Second Adhyaya, 21st sloka, ma'am. Yad Kurute lokastat anuver anuvatet.
Good. Next week, learn more perfectly. Very good, right? Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, you want to say something?
Yes. Ma'am, can I tell my experience? Ma'am, last time, Sri Padamali took the classes, no, ma'am, in the previous days. That day, one day I got the experience. Today it continued, I think. That day I got that I saw a bright white light, ma'am, in front of me. It was big. And Krishna came out of that light. He stayed, and after the meditation was completed, he vanished, ma'am, suddenly. So today also that continued. Like, he vanished. After that, he again came. That light came. And he again came. So I tried to ask that, is there any messages for me? Because Sri Padmini ma'am told, whenever you see again, you ask if you got some messages from Krishna. Then I asked, Krishna told that, no, I'm just observing that, are you doing good meditation? He told and vanished, ma'am.
Okay, very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
You heard Krishna speaking, no?
Yes.
Yes. Even if you have any questions also, you can ask him.
Ma'am?
Yes, Aditi.
Ma'am, do you know one thing, ma'am? Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, yes. Tell me, Aditri. No, I'm not able to hear you.
Ma'am?
Yes, Aditri, can you quickly tell? Many others are waiting.
Yes, ma'am. Today in my studies, first I have to join math class at 11:15. So before that, at 11 o'clock, 11 a.m. I just put some Radha and Krishna music and meditated, ma'am.
Good, very good. Yes. Before the class, if you meditate, you can grasp the class very easily. easily you can understand.
Okay.
Keep it up. Thank you. Kalyan? My God, 99 chats. Yes. Kalyan, can you unmute? Are you there? Yes, Kalyan. Yes, Kalyan, not able to hear you.
Ma'am, now?
Yes, I can.
Please, ma'am, so this experience?
Yes, yes.
One day, when I am going with Buddha, I saw Rama,
mm-hmm.
and Lakshmana, and Sita, ma'am.
Oh, okay.
Then I said, Rama, Lakshmana, and Sita, to come. Can you come to travel with me? And I said, they said yes, and we started traveling, ma'am.
Very
and
good.
We started traveling, three tigers had came, ma'am. Three tigers. I run and what I did is attack three plants, ma'am. After breaking three plants, I make it like meat, three meat, and throw it, ma'am. After that, I continue. Mm-hmm. After continuing, I saw a big monster. Mm-hmm. After that, I take a rainbow sword. Mm-hmm. And I cut his hands and legs, his body pieces, hands pieces, and legs like pieces. After that, we continued again. After we continued, a big mountain stopped us. It's so much high, man. What I did means, Buddha on my back, on my here, and Rama, Lakshmana, Sita also. And I jumped in one time, and I reached the mountain. After reaching the mountain, again, I saw Hanuman, man. After that, I take Hanuman also, and I go down to the mountain and we travel. The traveling, there are 10 Ravanas.
Mm-hmm.
Rotate it means I take the sword and they must order, kill him in the stomach, ma'am.
Oh.
The Ramayana, they will say.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
After that, we traveled again.
Mm.
Traveling again, mountain came.
Hmm.
Same thing I did. Go from the mountain and come down. After that, we go to the city now.
Hmm.
And Rama, Lakshmana, Sita said, this world is amazing. What is this called? They said. I said, this is called city. They will build so much buildings. And it will be good.
Mm.
And these are vehicles, I said, ma'am. After that, we traveled to my home, ma'am.
Mm.
That was my experience.
Yeah.
And today's experience is colors, ma'am. I only concentrate on my breath. After that, in concentrating on my breath only, I got this colors, ma'am.
Yeah, why we observe our breath is only to get rid of thoughts. Suppose you are able to see something, you just need to observe that. At that time, no need to observe your breath again. Okay, suppose some nature spot, you are there. So you can observe there. If some experience is happening inside, you can observe that.
Ma'am, I have a question, ma'am.
Yes.
When we meditate, we should not keep the chair like this, ma'am.
You should not touch the head to the wall or to sofa or anywhere.
Only you can touch the body and the
other parts you can touch, only the head. If you touch the head and sit back nicely, you will go to deep sleep. Okay, thank you, Kalyan. Very good experiences. Keep it up. Keep writing your experiences. Okay. Who else? Bhuvi, Ranita, Nikita. Yes.
Can I tell my experience of Bhagavad Gita sloka and what did I learn from you and one?
Yes.
Can I tell fourth adhyaya fifth sloka?
Just a second, Ranita. Just a second. I think Sai Krupa and Sai Saurabha. I think you are new, no? Can you just unmute and say what? If you have any doubts or.
Ma'am?
Yes, Sai Krupa.
You are teaching second adhyaya Bhagavad Gita second class, ma'am?
No, not second class, dear. So many classes are over. So you can follow from now.
Okay, ma'am.
If you want the earlier ones, it is there in, again, same Pyramid Hall Services, Meditation for Children. In that folder, you can find. Also, I think Bhagavad Gita is separate. Bhagavad Gita for children in English with Mahabharata stories. So that is the playlist name. So you can find all the Bhagavad Gita classes in that.
Okay, ma'am.
Are you following meditation? Sai Krupa and Sai Saurabha?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. If you have any doubts, you can even message.
Ma'am, can I share my experience?
Yes, dear. Quickly. Pranita, please.
Ma'am, in all class, I don't know that ma'am name. Mm-hmm. Ma'am told, I told that my old experience, what came, again that came, mm-hmm. again, that only coming, ma'am, that experience only for me in this
what
class.
What is that experience? What is that experience?
Anyone we can help means God we can see. We will do help anyone.
Mm-hmm.
God will see. God, we can see God.
Oh, wow. Amazing, dear. Yes. Very good. God is in everyone, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Not only in one statue or not only in one picture, but everything is God. The trees, the animals. That's why we should not cut the animals and eat. That's why we should not eat non-vegetarian food. You know what happened? One day when I was meditating, I think only 1 month, since I started meditation, I used to do a lot of pujas. Every day I used to collect flowers, all the parijata flowers I used to collect. So I used to take and nicely decorate God and do bhajans. A lot of this kind of thing is to happen from the very small age. So one day I was meditating. I don't know anything much because there are no classes, not much. Every day I'm sitting inside my home and meditating. One day, I was in deep meditation and here in the heart, in this place, I saw very bright light. Like the whole earth is illuminating. That much powerful it was, that much big light I could see. Then from that day onwards, I did not pray any God outside. Okay, I did not feel like praying from my inside. Then I realized, okay, everything is God, we are God. No need to pray anyone, but we need to see God in everyone. Suppose someone comes, they are very hungry. We need to give them food. Someone comes, they are very thirsty. We need to give water immediately. Someone is unable to cross the road. We need to help them. That is God. You told perfectly, Sai Krupa. Wonderful experience. Very good job. Very good. Keep it up. So we should know some animal is there. We should take care of that animal. We should tame it. We should talk to it. We should play with it. That is God. Some nice plants are there. We need to give water. That is God. Whatever you do, that is God, children. Yes, if you understand this, it's very simple. Life is very, very simple. Whatever act you do, it should be selfless. You should help everyone all the time. You should give food. You should teach them meditation. You should help them understanding why why vegetarian food is important, how it is impacting us. Okay, whatever act we do, it is God. Very good, Sai Krupa. Wonderful. Yes, Pranita.
Yeah, ma'am. Can I tell fourth Adhyaya and fifth Sloka? Bahutani Jarmani Tavajarjuna Tanyaham Veda Sarvani Natam Yeda Parandaba. Meaning of the sloka is, O Arjuna, you and me have taken many incarnations before this. I know all my incarnation and yours, but you don't know yours. And my experience was, ma'am, like I was meditating and I made a copper pyramid and I received so much cosmic energy. Then I don't know where I am. I just observing my breath and I don't know why I'm just sitting meditation. I don't know where I am. And you're talking about just 2 minutes. I just hear any person telling my name. I don't like, I can't hear that much. Like slowly one, you know. I just observe that. And like it's something happened, ma'am. Like I don't see really. Then I feel thirsty, so I just keep my hands on my eyes and just open my eyes.
Oh, wonderful experience, Vanita. Very good.
And what today is the it's tell a story, no ma'am, and Bhagavad Gita sloka, the first sloka. And what I learned is that should be interest and we should not attach it, just perform our duty.
Yes.
And do the work properly.
Yes.
And that day when we are doing oil pressing, you told no ma'am. When you are doing oil pressing, it are like very beautiful colors. Just observe the colors and do it, like any colors. Yesterday night, me and my mom cooking, ma'am. I just told my mom to see that vegetable's color and observe that how beautiful it is. Like me and my mom when we are cooking, just we observe the colors, ma'am.
Yes. Very good.
It was nice. Like bright and pale.
Yes. Very good, Sarita. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, Maulya. I'll give you opportunity. Bhuvi, Nikhila, please wait. Maulya.
Yes, ma'am.
Just a minute. If it is already 6:18 children, if anybody wants to leave, you can leave. Class is already over. I'm just listening to the experiences. Yes, Maulya, go ahead.
Ma'am, can I tell my yesterday's experience, ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, I was sitting down the tree and I was closing my hands to meditate. And I gone to a big, huge forest, ma'am.
Okay.
In that deep forest, I saw many deers and rabbits, everything, ma'am.
Wow, beautiful.
I made the friends of them, ma'am.
Very good, wow.
And one day, my friend deer was in trouble. I was helping, ma'am. The huge tiger attacked me. And my all friends helped me, ma'am.
Wow. Very good.
And I set them to meditate for 5 minutes, 2 minutes. Then they asked, why should we meditate, ma'am? Then I said, meditation will give the mind peacefulness, I said. And they also meditate with me, ma'am.
Wow. Good. Very good. You started teaching.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good, dear. Keep it up.
Thank you, ma'am.
Do you have any doubts? Okay, dear. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes, Bhuvi. Then Nikhila, last.
Ma'am,
Yes.
Ma'am, I want to tell one shloka because I don't want to waste the time. It's already time over. So, that 6th adhyaya, 13th shloka, ma'am. Okay. Samam kaya shiro grivam darayana chalam stiraha samprekshanasikagram swam dishaschanavalokayan. And one more doubt, ma'am. That is, we will go deep meditation, no, ma'am. Our head will be gone like this and it will touch, ma'am.
Sometimes if it touch naturally, it's okay. But we purposely should not touch it.
I will sit like this only, ma'am, but in deep meditation, it will go and touch the
If it goes like this, it's okay. Only this portion should not touch the...
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Nikhila?
Yeah, ma'am, I want to
share. That's a nice name to spell, you know, Nikhila.
Yeah, ma'am, I forgot.
Today I sang, while you all are meditating, today I sang you, what to say, some sargams kind of thing. Did you like it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
And I opened my eyes and I saw you, ma'am. Like, I want to see you when you are singing, ma'am.
Ayo. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, ma'am. So I want to share today's experience, ma'am. So when I was meditating, so for today's meditation music, so my head was like dancing, ma'am. And it is like vibrating feeling in this part, ma'am. Yeah, ma'am, that's
okay. Very good. When we get a lot of energy, all these experiences will happen. Good, Nikhila. Thank you. Hope it's done. Thank you so much, children. So let's meet tomorrow.